I've had a misery of a day working on a fucking TM recoil. Everything inside it, BTC Spectre, fucking Promi, everything. Of course it doesn't work properly. We're going to get that fucking BTC Spectre out because it's a fucking fail monkey. We're going to get a Titan in there. So what I'm doing now is I'm going to try and sort out an MP9 for somebody. This has got a busted disconnector, but I've got a very wrong feeling that it's going to be a little bit fucked up in other ways as well. These guns are very good. They're good. I like the MP9. But they get used wrong in the States, in Taiwan, in the UK. Now, the gas it's meant to use is this stuff, 134A. They are designed in Japan. The parts are made in Taiwan, assembled in Taiwan, shipped back to Japan, and then they get sold to be used with this gas. They are designed to break under the use of any gas that is not 134A, and that is why disconnectors fuck themselves. Now, when they make these for the Taiwanese market, they change the flute valve, or the rocket valve in this case, over to be aluminium rather than a piece of plastic, and that means it doesn't break quite as easily, but disconnector. Now, I know the ASG manual and the KWA manual tell you to use green gas. They're fucking wrong. Now, to drop the power in these, people generally install the CQB bolt, but the CQB bolt, that does drop the power. That doesn't solve your disconnector issue. And there are a lot of fucking guides on YouTube on how to get to your disconnector. I'm not doing one of those guides, all right? I'm going to do something that's a little bit different. This is my MP9. Mine is the same as this one. All internals are the same. Only difference, doesn't have the rail on the bottom. It's actually got the foregrip on it. And mine has got the OD top half because I think it looks cool as shit. And that's my one. As you can see, mine says Cal 9mm on it, not CQB like this one does, right there. So, mine is going to be lower powered than the customer's because I've done a modification to the inside to the rocket valve. That is the smarter way of doing it. There doesn't make any sense to go and buy an entire bolt assembly when you can literally take out a rocket valve and wrap a couple of fucking O-rings around it. Literally wrap a couple of O-rings around it, twisty figure of eight thing, and then reassemble the cunt back together, and suddenly the power drops. How about that? You could go to someone like Lee's Precision Engineering because he makes the actual downgrade rocket valves for these. They're not much. They're like 7, 8, 9 quid. They're not a lot. They're not the cost of an entire CQB bolt. Granted, these are a bit of a cunt to take apart, but if you've got the money and time sat there, you might as well figure out how to change it because you're going to be doing it a lot, because unfortunately these do break down a lot. So try to change out the disconnector with a steel one. And it looks like the fucking hammer's broken. This piece here should be attached to there, and it's not. It's completely off. So I'm going to try and find a way to drill it, tap it and thread it, and get that back on there. Now it's just a case of trying to figure out which fucking way around that went. That's how she'll look. Trouble is, now I've got to fucking assemble this with that not attached. So check that shit out. That's the part drilled through and pinned all the way through. Once it was all fitted, I had to go from the external of the body, so I had to make a small hole in the other side of the receiver. The screw went through all the way in to about the midway point. Then I angle ground it flat against the hammer pack. So now that goes on there. The bracing collar sits back on, and hopefully that will sit nicely. So that there is where I had to drill the hole out in order to get that pin through initially. As you can see,
Oh yeah.
Fucking knew it. Now you can see that this has been taken apart before.
There you go.
One exploded piston cup. That's now been replaced out with a Lee's Precision Engineering piston head. Nylon O-ring. Lovely. Honestly, how much cooler is it without that completely? Just, it's so much cooler like that. Look at it. Cooler. So this is the shit that no one tells you. Alright. People kind of leave this out and I don't know why. That onto there. Make sure that lines up nice and smoothly. This. Onto there. Notice how that entire thing moves forward. Take the entire unit, drop it like that. Then, disconnector back here, push it forward, drop your bolt in, back it goes. Keep the bolt back. Now, this here will continue to move. What you're going to do, plate, spring, slide it in there. Got that so far? Nice and easy, right? Here's the bit no one tells you. The little divot that you can see, there's only one divot and it faces towards you. That divot actually holds your outer barrel in place. So, by pushing the spring in, you'll find that point where that can then drop in to there. But you can notice that is not flush. See that? It's not flush. And that is because the outer barrel is not in place. That's the shit no one tells you. Wiggle the outer barrel until that can drop down into it. And then everything springs forward on its fucking own. Cool, right? Bolt forward, drop the hammer. Tiny problem with the MP9. The spring pressure has to overcome the forward pressure that the disconnector spring is applying. See that? Again, this is stuff that they don't tell you. You are never going to get consistency, and you're going to get more breakages if that spring pressure is not equal to the amount of pressure that that spring is applying. This is the standard spring that is inside the gun. As you can see, it is only just enough. When that bolt goes all the way back, that's as far as the bolt can go. Now check this out. This is a rubber pad. This rubber pad is to stop the bolt from hitting the steel block at the back. Except the bolt never touches got to make sure that everything is allowing that to touch. If that is not placed correctly, like that, you're going to get breakage issues. So make sure that that is definitely in place by checking that that bolt touches the rubber pad. At this point, you can test the gun. Locks back and empty. Does it fire? Of course it does. Halfway should give you semi-auto, and all the way should give you full. Again, stuff they don't tell you. Back to semi. It only allows the trigger to go back so far. That is now on there, nice and secure. See how the bolt moves? That is telling me there is not enough forward pressure being applied. Now that there is a very weak spring. Yeah. So that was no good. That is for an M4 mag catch, I believe. Let's see if that applies enough pressure. How much more fucking kicky that is now, and that is because the bolt is being pushed to the correct place. That's what we fucking want right there, a cluster of TMPs and MP9. And I think it's fair to agree that mine look better.